Welcome to a new Planetary Seismic update. First, I would like to show you the summary of what happened in the last week. We expected some increased seismic activity, potentially even a magnitude 7 earthquake, following the planetary conjunction Mercury-Venus-Neptune on the 11th. That did not happen. But if you look at the SGI graph here, magnitude 5.6 and larger, we see a couple of magnitude 6 earthquakes at the time, actually clustering of strong earthquakes at the time and just following the planetary conjunctions that I discussed in detail in the previous update. And it actually peaked magnitude 6.4, 6.5 at Vanuatu yesterday, following the Mars-Venus-Neptune conjunction. So no major earthquake so far. That means that the larger seismic activity is going to happen probably in the second week of August, as I have explained in previous updates. The second half of August is probably most critical, and because of the absence of larger earthquakes, it may become very critical, and we may see some really major seismic events in this next 2 weeks or so. So let's have a look at the planetary and lunar geometry in the coming week. We see a couple of planetary conjunctions. The peaks that will be on the 19th, 20th, Mars, Mercury, Neptune, and then Sun, Venus, Saturn on the 21st. And also we have Mars, Earth, Neptune on the 22nd. These are the three planetary conjunctions. Especially when Earth gets between Mars and Neptune, that is critical. We have critical lunar geometry before then and also after that planetary conjunction. So let's get into that. We have lunar geometry on the this morning, actually. This is on the 17th at 7:49 UTC, and that is when the Moon is in a conjunction with Saturn. Most critical will be when the Moon will be in conjunctions with Mars and Neptune, and that will be on the 19th, and there will be only be about 5 hours in between. That's going to be critical because it almost converges with Mars, Mercury and Neptune later on the same day. Then we see a high lunar peak on the 22nd, 23rd, early 23rd, and that will be when the Moon is making 135 and 45 angle geometry with Neptune and Mars. This is also critical because, as you can see, it happens practically at the same time with only a few minutes in between. It's going to be the tightest critical geometry with the Moon, Mars and Neptune in the coming week. And what you do not see on this graph here is that on the 26th of August, there will be very critical geometry again with Mars and Neptune, when the Moon makes opposite right angles with both outer planets. And we've seen in the past that that can result in really large seismic activity around 8.5 magnitude. But that can actually also happen with the conjunctions on the 19th. Overall, when we look at the planetary geometry on this SGI graph, from approximately the 19th to the 23rd will be very critical. And I expect, again, obvious clustering of stronger earthquakes, and we could see one or two magnitude 7 earthquakes here. This is probably the most critical time with this geometry with Mars and Neptune. And also what you do not see here is just outside of this SGI graph on the 26th, when the Moon makes the opposite right angles with Mars and Neptune. And we could see the largest seismic event potentially around the 28th as a result. We also see the purple labels here. That is geometry with Venus. And you see here at the bottom of the SGI graph, the dotted lines extended actually. And that is because Venus will be making 45 angle geometry with Jupiter and Neptune. And that will be exact on the 22nd, in early morning of the 22nd. But because Jupiter and Neptune do not move very fast, and Venus, relative to the position of Jupiter and Neptune, this 45 degree angle will be very active over several days, as you can see here. And mind you, the tolerance, the planetary tolerance, is only 0.17 degrees, which tells us that the dotted lines is marking the 45 degree angle, which will be pretty much exact over several days. And that adds to the critical geometry that we already have in this time frame. We also see some peaks on the dotted lines. That is Venus, Mercury, Uranus. That is 135 degrees. That is tomorrow morning. And we see that today there's also already Mercury, Venus, Uranus. And so we have Mercury, Venus, Uranus today, and then Venus, Mercury, Uranus tomorrow. This is not the critical right angle geometry that we've seen earlier this year that was followed by a magnitude 7.5, 7.7 earthquakes. This is 45 and 135 degrees, a bit less critical, but still I expect a seismic increase following this planetary geometry. And, well, as you can see, we have very critical planetary geometry coming up. Again, I expect seismic increase, clustering of stronger earthquakes. One or two magnitude 7 earthquakes is very, very likely. And in a worst case scenario, an earthquake over magnitude 8. That can already happen in the coming week. It is also possible that the largest seismic event will happen in the last week, around 28th of August. If we look at some additional planetary geometry here, this is very interesting. Tomorrow, or actually on the 18-19th, we have some very interesting planetary geometry with Jupiter, the Sun and Saturn as they are making a 30, 60, 90 degree angle. And that is right in the middle of the critical planetary geometry that we have. This is very unique planetary geometry with the largest celestial bodies in the solar system. And what that will add to the geometry, that is not certain, but it is pretty unique that we have this beautiful angle, right angle, triangle in the solar system. Again, the 30 degree angle with Saturn, the 60 degree angle with the Sun, and the 90 degree angle with Jupiter. Very interesting geometry on top of the critical geometry that we already have in the coming week. If we look at the atmospheric fluctuations so far, the strongest fluctuations occurred actually on the 12th, and they mark regions in the East Pacific, the southern tip of Chile, and I'd say pay special attention to Central and North America based on these fluctuations. And also, I marked them here as with the circles around the fluctuations. The first circle actually emphasizes the fluctuations on the East Pacific side, and later on the 12th we had a very strong fluctuation marking on the West Pacific, and that is Papua New Guinea to the north, the Philippines, maybe a bit of eastern part of Indonesia, and further to the north, Taiwan, maybe even eastern part of China. Of course, if it's a bit to the east and to the west, it could include Japan, and we have to wait and see. These are the strongest fluctuations so far. We will keep monitoring the fluctuations and add them to the website, so be sure to check out the website for the latest updates. This is the update so far. Have an earthquake plan. We are probably going to have some strong major earthquakes in the coming week. We have very critical geometry with Mars and Neptune. We shouldn't underestimate that. It could reach mid-8 magnitude in a worst case scenario. Stay safe. Until next time.